106-pound finalists, or semifinalists, you will be up following the 157-pound and 150-pound bouts. We're moving you guys up a little bit. 106-pound semifinalists will be up here in just a few minutes.
Thank you.
workers, if you would select mat one and then back to mat two, that match will show up. We're going to go ahead and move that 285-pound bat to mount two as well. That will be the last match of this round. 285, Sadler and Adamson, you guys are up on mat two. Thank you. wrestlers and spectators, in the conclusion of this match, we'll have a short break when we get things ready for the finals round. When we wrestle finals, we will wrestle first place matches on the green mat. Third place matches will be wrestled on the white mat. And we will wait to the conclusion of both matches before starting the next weight class. We also have a consolation semifinal at 106 that we will wrestle at 2:55. So their 45-minute wait time will be up at 2:55. Consolation semifinal 106, 2:55. The rest of them will flow through first place on the green mat, third place on the white mat.
live just outside of Austin. So we flew in last night to be here to share some thoughts on somebody who's had a huge impact not only in my life, but on a lot of the moms that came back today. Before I get into some of the things that Coach did for us and impacted our lives, let me share a little bit about his accolades as a coach. He had 413 dual wins. Jeff Conn was the most in the state. 14 conference championships, 18 district championships, 7 district runner-ups, 215 state qualifiers, 76 state placers, 15 state champions, 2 two-time state champions, and 14 conference champions. That's your dad. Wow, his coaching career from a box scores perspective was extremely impressive. I assure you, none of those are the things that are the reason we're here to honor him today. It's the imprint that he left on countless Newfoundland's lives, turning us from boys into men, putting his piece of straw on the camel's back of Maryville, which now refers to itself as Title Town, which I can tell you when I was in the sixth grade, that seemed a far cry from reality. He did it in his own sort of Calvin sort of way. So I actually went by a cowboy hat just to honor him today. It was on his retirement, we had an opportunity. There were a handful of us that got together to roast Coach Drake, and Clint Cochran kicked it off. And he got up and he said, wrestling's an interesting sport. It attracts kids from all walks of life. You get, kids that do well in school, kids that don't do well in school, kids that, two-parent homes, single-parent homes. He said the beauty of Coach Drake was he treated us all equally bad. And that was true. Watching the Spoofhounds wrestle back in the day was a lot of fun, but I can tell you the wrestling room was anything but. And the reason for that was if it was hard, we were going to do it. And Coach Drake put us through a ringer that I'm quite sure some of us after just a few months probably could have banged out a Navy SEAL Hell Week in what Coach called practice. I remember getting to college and thinking about how easy our practices were by comparison to what Coach ran us through. But what he taught us was that anything in life worth doing is difficult. Thank you, Coach Drake. Coach Drake also taught us something that it's missing in a lot of places in life today that I also think is critically important, and it's respect. He taught us how to respect ourselves. He taught us how to respect our teammates. He taught us how to respect our parents. And he taught us how to respect our opponents. And Coach Drake, he always hated to showboat. He would say, whatever you do when you win is what you're going to do when you lose. So if you want to get up and wave your hands or shoot guns, try to humiliate your opponent, that's fine. But you're going to do it when you lose, too. As a result of that, we won very quietly. We'd get up, shake our opponent's hand, we'd get our hands raised, and we'd walk off the mat. He taught us that winning with dignity and winning quietly with humility was the only way to do it. Thank you, Coach Drake. Taught us that self-improvement was for everybody. Coach Drake was an interesting coach. You see, it's rare I coach these guys in Little League. I don't adhere to it either. But Coach Drake never really said much during matches. He would always sit in the corner, other than telling us what position we were going to take at a period. He would just talk to the students sitting next to him and make notes about our flaws and our technique and things that needed to get corrected. Then the day after a match, we'd sit down on the wall and we'd go through each one of the weight classes and all the mistakes that we had made. Now, I had a pretty decent high school wrestling career, right? I only lost a handful of matches and I didn't lose a single match after my sophomore year. But I never heard good job from Coach Drake. The way Coach Drake would pass a compliment to you was he just skipped over your weight class. But what I learned, what my fellow teammates learned, was that self-improvement was for everybody. And that we could all get better. And that we could learn from our peers in the process of doing so. Thank you, Coach Drake. dissecting ourselves was critical, that self-improvement is critical to development, and the only way to do it is by respecting yourself, respecting your peers, respecting your opponents, and respecting the people that helped you get there. And with that, Coach, please come out. We'd like to honor you in something that I think is not only long past due, but coaches and teachers like you, Coach, are what allow the men that are here today to become who we are, and we're forever grateful for the blessings. Thank you.
First place and third place wrestlers, go ahead. We'll give you about 5 minutes to get warmed up. If you'd like to, we'll start rolling. Again, at 255, we will wrestle that consolation 106-pound bat, 255 sharp. Everything else should roll straight through. 5 minutes if you want to get warmed up, we'll get started. Thank you.
Coach Drake's former wrestlers with Coach Drake, so we've got to make our way over here. We're going to try to head up into the stands and snap a couple pictures really quick. So, again, all the very cool wrestling alumni, all the fellows that are here for Coach Drake, please come on down here. We'll set you up in front of the band there to get a picture. Thank you.
Coach Drake. For those of you warming up, we'll clear the mat. Maryville's done taking their photos with Coach Drake. Go ahead and keep warming up. Reminder, we will be starting this round with the 113-pound weight class. The consolation semifinal for 106 pounds. Those will be wrestled at 255 on the nose. Wrestlers, let's clear the mats. In your championship match at 113 pounds, Dylan Lair from Rockport versus place match, Brian Bailey of Cameron.
Yeah.
place match. The white mat, Clayton Yentis, Cameron, and Lucas Manol Sabetha. Your championship bout, 120 pounds, Caleb Lucas of Rockville, Dane Henderson of Perryville. Table workers, we will be running those 106 pounds. Bart, and Cameron. In your championship bout, 126 pounds, Augustus Hines of Rockport, and Tanner Turner of Marysville.
Thank you.
32 pounds, Colin Winkle, Sabatha, Cody Hewins of Lafayette Riverside.
Thank you.
238 pounds, Colin Manole. Rebecca.
Yellow. Right.
150-pound champion, Tuff Johnston.
Thank you.
last at 197 pounds. In your third place bout, Tyler Axis Campbell. Bracken Collier, Malair. In your championship bout at 157 pounds, Dayton Evans, Winnetonka, and Logan Reynolds.
Thank you.
at 157 pounds, Tate Evans of Winnetonka.
Thank you.
Wyatt Grant, Plattsburgh.
Thank you.
Jake Kunze, Sabetha. 2:15. Your third place bout, Jordan Colon, Winnetonka.